Hello friends, welcome to engineering tutorial. So we'll continue our discussion related to electrical machines, and in the last video and this video we are going to touch some concepts related to network theory which are required for our discussion related to transformers. So the previous video we discussed about phasor diagrams, the AC circuits. And in this video we are going to discuss about coupled circuits. So this is required for our understanding, a better understanding of transformers. Okay, so before discussing coupled circuits we should have a good understanding of inductance, then we can understand the concept of coupled circuits. Okay, so what is inductance? So inductance is the property of a circuit element which opposes any change in the rate of change of current flowing through a circuit. Okay, di by dt, that's why I say L is V by di by dt. So because of that it opposes the rate of change of current with respect to time. So when a current flows through a circuit, let's say we have an inductor coil here of n turns, and it is connected through to an AC supply, a current I flows through the coil. So when this current flows through the coil, it produces a magnetic flux, let's say it is called as phi. So because of this flux produced in the coil, a voltage, an EMF will be induced in it. There are two expressions for this voltage or EMF induced. First, V is L di by dt, where L is the inductance, di by dt is the rate of change of current. Second expression is, as per Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, this EMF induced V will be N d phi by dt, the rate of change of flux. So when we equate these two equations 1 and 2, we will get L di by dt is equal to N d phi by dt. Or we can write it as Li is equal to N phi, dt dt gets cancelled, we integrate both sides, we get Li is equal to N phi, or L is equal to N phi by I. You understand? We cancel dt, we integrated both sides, we get Li is equal to N phi, or L is equal to N phi by I. So here I'm just going in a quick way. Coupled circuits itself is a very vast chapter, we'll discuss it in the network theory section in detail, don't worry about that, we'll have a very good discussion on it. But here I'm just going in a quick way so that we can take our discussions related to transformer a little bit forward. Okay, so we can write inductance as N phi by I. N, number of turns of coil, phi is the flux produced, and I is the circuit current. Now, coupled circuits. Now, two circuits, they are said to be coupled if flux of each circuit links with the other. So this coupled circuit concept, it becomes very important for our discussion on transformers. Why? Because we know in transformers we have laminated magnetic core, primary winding which is essentially consists of inductance, secondary coil same inductance. When we connect an AC supply, current flows through the primary coil, produces a flux, then as a result of which EMF is induced, that generates EMF E2 here because of this mutual flux. The whole story goes on. So these two circuits are coupled circuits because flux of primary coil links with the secondary coil, flux produced in secondary coil links with the primary coil. So this mutual flux, the flux of one coil linking with the other, the flux of this coil linking with this, that is what generates the or induces the EMF, or the energy conversion from primary to secondary takes place. Whether it is step up or step down, it depends on the number of turns. That is a different thing. But all of this happens because of this coupled circuit phenomena. Mutual flux, flux of one coil linking with the other. There is no electrical connection, direct electrical connection between primary and secondary side. They are connected through this mutual flux. They are coupled together through this mutual flux. That is why the concept of coupled circuit is very important to understand when we are discussing about transformers. So, when it comes to coupled circuits, two parameters are very important: self-inductance and mutual inductance. For coupled circuits, mutual inductance M is very important because mutual flux plays a vital role in the operation of the transformer. Leakage flux does not play any role. I have already told in the introductory video, leakage flux is the flux which is produced in a particular coil and does not link with the other coil. Suppose current flows through the primary coil, a primary flux will be produced. The portion of the primary flux that does not link with the secondary winding is called as leakage flux. Similarly, total flux produced by the secondary winding, let's say it is called as secondary flux. Now, the portion of the secondary flux that does not link with the primary winding, that is called as leakage flux. Leakage flux does not play any role in transformer action. Mutual flux plays the vital role, the entire role here. So, let's say we have two coils, inductor coils, N1, N2. V1 is connected at the primary winding side, let's say the primary or the coil 1. V2 is the output voltage here that we get. I1 and I2 are the current flowing. Let the total flux at coil 1 because of the current flow is phi subscript 1. Let it be phi 11 plus phi 12. Here the total flux at coil 2 side is phi 22 plus phi 21. So here phi 1 is the total flux of coil 1. Phi 2 is the total flux of coil 2. Phi 11 is, understand this, phi subscript 11 is the flux of coil 1 which links with itself, okay, which links with itself, coil 1 itself. Flux of coil 1 or flux produced by coil 1 linking with coil 1 itself. It is leakage flux. Phi 12 is flux of coil 1 linking with coil 2, flux produced by coil 1 linking with coil 2, this big circle, that is phi 12. This is mutual flux. Phi 12 is mutual flux, common flux. Phi 11 is leakage flux. Similarly, here phi 2 is the total flux of coil 2. Phi 22 is the flux produced by coil 2 linking with coil 2 itself. Flux phi 21 is flux produced by coil 2 linking with coil 1. This is mutual flux. This is common flux, phi 21. Phi 22 is leakage flux. Does not play any role in transformer. Okay? So phi 1 is phi 11 plus phi 12, phi 2 is phi 22 plus phi 21, and this is equal. Phi 21 is phi 12. So, here for coil 1, we can say that the self-inductance will be L1 N1 Phi1 by I1, where total flux of coil 1 comes into play. For coil 2, self-inductance is L2 is N2 Phi2 by I2, where I1 is the coil current flowing through coil 1, I2 is the current flowing through coil 2. N1 number of turns of coil 1, N2 is number of turns of coil 2. And Phi1 and Phi2 are the flux related to associated with coil 1 and coil 2 as per this formula. Next is mutual inductance, where mutual flux comes into play, which is very important from the point of view of transformer actions. For mutual flux, mutual inductance, mutual flux will come into play, phi 12, phi 21. So M can be represented as N2 phi 1 2 by I 1. So please realize the importance of this equation. Mutual inductance M can be represented as N2, number of turns of coil 2, N2, then phi 1 2, which means flux of coil 1 linking with coil 2. Phi 1 2 is flux of coil 1 linking with coil 2. So flux produced by coil 1 linking with coil 2, number of turns of coil 2. Next is this denominator I1. I1, because flux of one coil 1 is involved and flux of coil 1 is produced by current I1. So realize the importance of these terms. N2, because flux of coil 1 is linking with coil 2, that's why number of turns of coil 2, N2. And because flux of coil 1 is linking with coil 2, flux of coil 1 is produced by current I1, that's why here I1. Similarly, mutual inductance can be represented in the opposite way. N1 phi 21 by I2. N1, number of turns of coil 1. Phi 21 is flux produced by coil 2 linking with coil 1. It is linking with coil 1, that's why number of turns of coil 1. Flux of coil 2 is produced by current I2, so that's why in the denominator I2. It is all related to this equation. We are getting it from this general equation which we just got from these two equations. Okay, so you realize the importance of all these terms for mutual inductance and self-inductance. Okay, next is coefficient of coupling. So it is the fraction of the total flux that links with the other coil. So basically it is the ratio between the mutual flux or the common flux and the total flux. So it can be represented, it is given by small k, which is phi 12 by phi 1, which is equal to phi 21 by phi 2, because phi 12 and phi 21, they are the same. So phi 12 by phi 1, that is flux of coil 1 linking with coil 2, by divided by the total flux. Here it is flux of coil 2 linking with coil 1 divided by the total flux of coil 2. And it is also given by the ratio between the mutual inductance and the square root of the product of the self-inductance of coil 1 and coil 2, M by root over of L1, L2. So this is the coefficient of coupling. So in the discussion, when we'll have this discussion in network theory section, we will derive all of these things. We will have a very long discussion related to this. So here I just went about in a quick way, so that we can take our discussion related to transformers forward. Okay, so here we have discussed related some concepts related to coupled circuits. Okay, so I hope you like this video, and please subscribe to my channel Engineering Tutorial for more such videos related to electrical, electronics, instrumentation and communication engineering. Have a great day. Thank you very much.